Let's discuss a concept called principle of mutual exclusion and inclusion. So using this concept, we can solve some counting problems. Okay. The idea about principle of this mutual exclusion inclusion is, you have, let's say, a problem which is represented as a union of some sets. That means your problem is nothing but A union B and you want to count it. Okay. Then you want to count the size of this, that is equal to size of A plus size of B minus size of A intersection B. This is called principle of mutual exclusion and inclusion. Okay, so using that, we can count the number of elements in A union B set. Okay, we can extend this problem to multiple sets, that means more than two elements. Example, your set is A union B union C. That means your problem is written as union of three sub problems A, B, C. Then the total number of elements in A union B union C, you want to count it, then equal to count A plus count B plus count C, and remove all the, you know, intersection of two elements like A intersection B, okay, A intersection C minus B intersection C. So I removed all the, you know, two intersections. After that, add this time three size intersections, otherwise intersection of three sets, any three sets. We have only one combination of three sets, that's why it is A intersection B intersection C. Now see the formula again, mod of A union B union C equal to mod A plus mod B plus mod C, and remove all the two intersections, add three intersection. That's it. You can extend this formula to, you know, any length. That means this is three length formula, this is two length formula. In that way, you can extend it to any length. Let's take, you know, a general form where you have n sets. So in your problem, you have n sets like this: A1 union, A2 union, A3, so on, An. Then what is the formula for this one? So because we have some logic, right? Using that, we try to write, you know, a formula in a readable form. First, the answer, if you see, we have to add all the one size sets, that means, you know, individual sets, isn't it? For that, I use sigma. I have to add all the sets. Then subtraction. Subtract what? All the two intersections. So again, it's a sigma of, you know, AI intersection AJ, isn't it? I want to say that here I'm using I comma j to represent all the sets. Like I is a variable which goes from 1 to n, j is a variable which goes from 1 to n. Okay, now AI intersection AJ, that means any two combination. Okay, now after that, add all the three combinations: sigma AI intersection AJ intersection AK. So in that way you can continue it, so on. Then one fine day you reach to end, and that end we have to write what? Full combination. That means A1 intersection, A2 intersection, A3 intersection, so on, AN. Okay, so what is the sign of this one? If you see the pattern, plus minus plus minus, so on, this will be, you see here, you can understand. For last set, it is minus. For last component here, it is plus. That means when there are three elements, it is positive. When there are two elements in the set, that means when you have two elements in union, then it is minus. For four, it will be plus in that way. So it will be minus 1 whole to the power of n minus 1. It is easy to observe, isn't it? So finally, if n value is 2, 2 minus 1 will become odd number 1. Minus 1 whole to the power of 1, negative. If n equal to 3, this kind of formula, then n will become, you know, n minus 1 will become 2. Minus 1 whole square is positive, isn't it? In that way, so this minus 1 whole to the power of n minus 1 can take care of parity. Okay, so this is a formula we are going to use and solve lot of problems. Okay, so let's try to learn how to apply principle of mutual exclusion inclusion. Okay, for that we see the problems. Problem number one, you have binary sequences. We want to find out the number of binary sequences of length 8, starts with 0 or ends with 1 1. Okay, so length 8, Let me take 8 positions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Assume that all such sequences which starts with 0, because question is either they should start with 0 or ends with 1, 1. Let's denote S0 as number of binary sequence of length 8 which starts with 0. Now S11 is all the strings of length 8 which are of course binary sequences which ends with 11. Now our solution is, or our problem is computing them, isn't it? So I want to count all the numbers which starts with 0, that means S0 set union S11, isn't it? So because these are all binary sequences starts with 0, these are all binary sequences starts ends with 11, then you want all, then union them, right? And I taught you sum rule, correct? So why a sum rule cannot be applied, I will tell you. So if you apply sum rule, then what happens? Mod of S0 union S11, which is our problem, equal to mod S0 plus mod S11, isn't it? So this is general formula, sum rule. But sum rule cannot be applicable because there are some sequences which you are counting here because they are starting with 0, and there are same sequences which are ending with 11. Then such sequences, I am talking about a sequence which starts with 0, ends with 11. Then you count only one sequence, such sequence, here and here. So it's a duplicate. We should eliminate it. That's why we have to use principle of mutual exclusion inclusion. When I taught you sum rule, clearly I told you that to apply sum rule, the intersection between the sets which you are using should have, you should not have no elements, right? Their intersection should be empty. But here the intersection might not be empty here. That's why you simply use principle of mutual exclusion inclusion. That's why it will become S0 intersection S11. In one line, if the corresponding sets which you are talking about doesn't have any common element, go for sum rule. Otherwise, we have to apply principle of mutual exclusion inclusion. Okay. Now let's do it. First, we count mod S0. If you know the description, it will be very easy to count. Let's recall what is description of S0. All the sequences which starts with 0. So how many sequences possible which starts with 0? Where there are 8 positions. Simple, right? If there is no condition, answer 2 to the power of 8. But here we have to fix 0. Then only we have option for other 7 positions. Then each position can be filled with 2 ways. Then 2 into 2 into 2 into, according to product rule, it will be 2 to the power of 7, right? So mod S0 is 2 to the power of 7. Now, what is mod S11? Number of sequences which ends with 11. Then you write 11 at the end. Remaining positions are 6. So each position can be filled in 2 ways. Then there are 6 such positions. Then 2 power 6 ways we can change them. Then 2 to the power of 6 such sequences. So we got the answer. So mod of S0 union S11, according to the formula, mod S0 2 to the power of 7 plus mod S11 2 to the power of 6 minus, see, there is one more problem. What is that? S0 intersection S11. What is that? See, S0 is all binary sequences which starts with 0. S11 is all binary sequences which ends with 11. Then what is common pattern? Common pattern contains 8 positions and it starts with 0 and it ends with 11. Then only it will become common for that two sets. So that finally, so such set is with 8 positions, starts with 0, ends with 11. There are 5 other positions can be optional, like can be varied. How many ways you can vary 5 positions? 2 to the power of 5 ways. That's why there are 2 to the power of 5 such sequences, common sequences. Now if you simplify it, you get 128 plus 64 minus 32. So 128 plus 64 minus 32 is 32. 128 plus 32 is 160, isn't it? In that way, easily we can solve principle of mutual exclusion inclusion problems. Okay, we'll see one more problem. It is easy to solve, but I want to teach you because it comes under principle of mutual exclusion inclusion. Okay, we'll see this problem. In a room containing 28 people, there are 18 people who speak English. So they have given individual values, like who speak English, who speak Hindi, and who speak Kannada. Then they have given combinations. 9 people speak both English and Hindi, 11 persons speak Hindi and Kannada, and 13 persons speak Kannada and English. So every value is given. Then how many people speak all three languages? Okay, this problem can be represented as a set form, isn't it? I want to say that the people who speak English, let me denote it by E, and the people who speak Kannada, let me represent it by K, and people who speak Hindi, let me represent by H. So E, H, K. So now I want to find out the total number of people who speak all three languages. That means it's not E union H union K, it is E intersection H intersection K, right? So the people who speak English and Hindi and Kannada, I want common people, right? So every set represents the people who speak a language, right? So E represents who speak English, and this one who speak Hindi, and this who speak Kannada. Now we know formula for E union H union K, that's why I wrote it first. Okay, so what is the formula for this one? In this formula, so this component is contained. Let me write the formula for E union H union K. So E union H union K equal to mod E plus mod H plus mod K, isn't it, minus E intersection H minus E intersection K minus H intersection K. After that, we have to add all the three size intersections, E intersection H intersection K. This is the formula for E union H union K. But is it given, like how many people speak either English or Hindi or Kannada? Kannada, in a room there are 28 people, right? So we should assume that, so they speak either English or Hindi or Kannada. Okay, let me assume like that. So then this will become 28. So 28 equal to mod E, who speak English? 18 people speak. How many? 18. Now how many people speak Hindi? 15. 18 plus 15 plus Kannada people are 22 minus E intersection H. So common between English and Hindi, who speak both English and Hindi, is 9. Right, we have to find out common people of Hindi and Kannada. So that is 11. And after that, minus Hindi and next one is Hindi and Kannada is 11. 9 is English and Hindi. Third one is English and Kannada. So English and Kannada is given as, see here, Kannada and English 13. Right, remove it, plus E intersection H intersection K. So the people who speak all three languages, which is unknown, X. We have to find out X value. Okay, then X equal to, you know, we have to send this all these people that side. 28 minus, let me simplify this one, 18 plus 15, 33 plus 22, 55. 28 minus 55. Then all these minus numbers will go and they will become positive. It will become 9, 11, 20, 33. So it's a mathematics, right? So simple manipulation. 55, 28 plus 33, 41, 61. 61 minus 55, which is nothing but 6. So the people who speak Hindi, English and Kannada is 6 using this formula. It's just application of the formula. Everyone can understand it. Okay, so answer is 6. Option B. Let's see one more problem. How many integers between 1 to 1000 are divisible by 2 or 3 or 5 is a problem. Okay, this problem is again, you know, an example of principle of mutual exclusion inclusion. That's why we are solving it. So we'll solve it. How many integers between this 1 to 1000 are divisible actually by 2 or 3 or 5? For that, I represent like this. First, I solve S2 problem. All the numbers between 1 to 1000 which are divisible by 2. Similarly, S3 is all the numbers which are divisible by 3 in the range 1 to 1000. Similarly, S5 is all the numbers which are divisible by 5. Then S2 union S3 union S5 is what? Think about it. It's a union, all the numbers which are either type of this or this type or this type. This type means which are divisible by 2, this type means divisible by 3 and divisible by 5. So finally, when you do union of all that numbers, they are either this or this or this, that means they are divisible by 2 or divisible by 3 or divisible by 5, isn't it so? Then we have to compute the size of such set, right? So according to principle of mutual exclusion inclusion, we have a formula for it, isn't it? It is nothing but mod s2 plus mod s3 plus mod s5 minus two size intersections, s2 intersection s3 and s3 intersection s5 minus s2 intersection s5 plus s2 intersection s3 intersection s5. We have to compute each and every set's value, right? Size of that set. Let's begin with s2. How many numbers between 1 to 1000 are divisible by 2? So that is equal to, very simple, every second number is divisible by 2, right? So in from 1 to 4 there are 2 such numbers, between 1 to 6 there are 3 such numbers, right? Every second. So if there are 1000 numbers, if I take every second, then there will be 1000 by 2, isn't it? So that's why it will be 1000 by 2. Now mod s3, how many integers between 1 to 1000 are divisible by 3? Every third. So formula would become 1000 by 3. But this is not an integer, right? You get 333 point something. Then either should I take 333 or 334 is the question. Simple. So up to 999 there are 333. Up to 999 there are 999 by 3 integers which are divisible by 3. Then suddenly up to 1000 there is no extra number, right? Like, so if I increase the numbers to 1000, then you are not getting one more, right? So that means whatever the numbers between 1 to 999 are divisible, same thing is divisible, right? So what I want to say is we should take floor rather than ceiling. So whenever it is 333.333, so only there are 333 numbers which are divisible, but not 333.33 or not 334, right? So third one, s5, the numbers from 1 to 1000 which are divisible by 5 is 1000 by 5, again floor. So for you know commonality, I am taking everywhere floor, okay? Though here it is not required, I am writing, not a problem, right? So now we have mod s2, mod s3, mod s5. We need mod of s2 intersection s3. So s2 intersection s3, first understand the description of that set. What is that description? S2 is all the numbers which are divisible by 2, s3 is all the numbers which are divisible by 3. Then what is common? Common number is nothing but it is divisible by 2 and divisible by 3. So such elements are in s2 intersection s3. Then I can say that numbers are divisible by 2 and 3. Any number is divisible by 2 and 3 is divisible by 6, isn't it? So directly I can say that they are divisible by 6, right? So how many numbers which are divisible by 6 then? 1000 by 6. That's why such numbers are 1000 by 6. Understand? Now s2 intersection s5. What is this set? All the numbers which are divisible by 2 and 5. Really a number is divisible by 2 and 5. Automatically it is divisible by 10, isn't it? Because whenever a number, let's take a number x, if it is divisible by 2, then you will have 2 as factor. And if it is divisible by 5, you also will have 5 as factor. Whenever you have a factor 2 factor 5, then you have a factor 10. That means automatically that will become, you know, that will be divisible by 10. Let's do it. So number of such numbers are 1000 by 10. Now we'll see s2 intersection s3 over s2 intersection s5 over next s3 intersection s5. So that is equal to 1000 by, so divisible by 3 and divisible by 5, that means divisible by 15, then it will be 1000 by 15, right? So we have calculated all the values except this s2 intersection s3 intersection s5. So s2 intersection s3 intersection s5 is, you know, all the numbers which are divisible by 2, divisible by 3, divisible by 5. So that means your number should have 2 as a factor, 3 as a factor, 5 as a factor. For that it should be divisible by 30. So it will be 1000 by, you know, 30. So these are all the values. Now we have values, we have formula, it's all about simplification. Now let's simplify it. Answer will be 1000 by 2, 500 plus 1000 by 3, 333. Okay. 1000 by 5 plus 200 minus 1000 by 6. It will be, I have to simplify it. So rather than simplifying it, let me write it directly. And 1000 by 10. Okay. And after that, minus 1000 by 15 plus 1000 by 30. So this is a formula. Okay. Of course, floor. So simplify it, you get the answer. That's it. Okay. Let's see one more problem. How many integers between 1 to 1000 are divisible by 4 or 6 or 10? So what's the difference between previous problem and this problem? There is no much difference, but the values 4, 6, 10 are not prime numbers. In the previous example, they were 2, 3, 5. They were prime numbers. There is small difference. Okay. While solving the problem, you understand it. So we know that answer is S4 union, S6 union, S10, right? So, and we know the formula for it. Simply write the formula. And when it comes to S4 intersection S6, that is all the numbers which are divisible by 4 and divisible by 6. So how many such numbers are possible? That is not 1000 by 24. Okay. So that will be 1000 by, LCM of 4, 6. I will tell you the reason for it. So out of 1000, if a number is divisible by 4, it should have a factor. Example, your number is x. Okay. That number is divisible by 4, then this x should have a factor 4. Okay. That means x will have a factor 4. 4 is nothing but 2 into some extra. I don't know the extra part. But definitely you have 4. Otherwise, it is not divisible, isn't it? Now, same number, it is divisible by 6, then it should have 6 factor. Now, to see the 6, I don't require to see a separate 6. Already we have 2, right? Then you should have 3 more, right? Now finally, the essential thing is your number should have 2 2s, 1 3, right? Then automatically it will be divisible by 4, divisible by 6, isn't it? Divisible by 6, divisible by 4. So finally, you should have 2 and 2 and 3. That is nothing but, this process is nothing but calculating LCM, right? So least common multiples. So the numbers which are divisible by 1000 are LCM of which are divisible by 4 or 6 are nothing but which are divisible by 12, right? So that will become 1000 by 12. In the same way, we have to compute S4 intersection S10, S6 intersection S10. So you get the answer for this one. I'm not simplifying it. Okay, you can do it. But only thing you should know that it is LCM of 4, 6. Similarly, for this one, LCM of 6, 10, LCM of 4, 10, we need to compute. Then finally, LCM of 4, 6, 10. That's it. This is about this problem. Okay. The numbers between 1 to 1000, which are relatively prime numbers to 30. Here, you should understand a concept called relatively prime. Example, if I say x is relatively prime to y, that means there is no common prime factor. That's it. It's very simple. So you know that prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, so on, right? Between any two numbers, if there is no common prime factor, they are relatively prime numbers. Example, 24 and maybe 125. Just you see. To check whether there is a common prime factor or not, we have to write, first all prime factors. Let me do the factorization. So it is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, isn't it? 24. 125 is 5 into 5 into 5. Now there is no common prime factor. That's why these two are relatively prime numbers, 24 and 125. So 36 and 54, let's try that. 36 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 to the 4, 4 9s. 9 means 3 into 3. I'm writing all, factors of prime numbers. 54 is nothing but 3 into 18. So 18 is 2 into 9, 9 is 3 into 3, right? So 2, 3, 2, 3. So all are common here, right? So 36, 54 are not relatively prime numbers. Okay. So using this concept, so we are going to answer this question. So how many numbers between 1 to 1000 are relatively prime numbers to 30? Okay. So if you observe first prime factors of 30, they are nothing but 2 into 3 into 5. So it is easy to calculate non-relatively prime numbers. I will tell you why. Any non-relatively prime number will have 2 as a factor, or 3 as a factor or 5 as a factor, right? So that's why non-relatively prime numbers are well defined, okay, for us especially. So we know how to calculate them. Let's denote all non-relatively prime numbers of 30 as, you know, which are either divisible by 2 or divisible by 3 or divisible by 5. Isn't it so? So think about opposite set. Like, what is this opposite of this set? Think about it, which is complement of this one. First understand this set so that complement will be easy for you. This set is union of all the set numbers which are divisible by 2 or divisible by 3 or divisible by 5. Opposite of that, that means the opposite set is the numbers which are neither divisible by 2 nor divisible by 3 nor divisible by 5, so that they don't have this as factors. So they are relatively prime numbers. That's why finally we want to calculate S2 union S3 union S5 whole bar. But I don't do bar first, okay? Let me do this, you know, without bar first. It is, you know, well-known thing for us. Principle of mutual exclusion, inclusion. Let me solve it. So how many numbers between 1 to 1000 are this kind of thing? So they will be, we know the formula directly, 1000 by 2 plus 1000 by 3 plus 1000 by 5, isn't it? Of course, floor minus 1000 by LCM of 2, 3, which is 6, minus 1000 by LCM of 3, 5, 15, minus 1000 by LCM of 2, 5, which is 10, plus 1000 by LCM of 2, 3, 5, which is 30. So let me simplify this one. 1000 by 2 is 500, 1000 by 3 is 333, 1000 by 5 is 200, 1000 by 6 you get 166, 1000 by 15 you get 66, 1000 by 10 you get, you know, some 100, 1000 by 30 you get 33. Okay, if you simplify it, you get 734. Okay, so remember, that means there are 734 numbers in 1 to 1000 which are either divisible by 2 or 3 or 5. They are not my numbers. My numbers are which are not this kind of numbers. So then you simply remove from 1000. 1000 are total numbers. Out of them, 734 are opposite number. That means, you know, who doesn't have a property of relatively prime, right? So remaining numbers, 1000 minus 734, which are, of course, you know, 266. There are 266 numbers which are relatively prime numbers to 30. Okay, because they are neither divisible by 2, not divisible by 3, not divisible by 5. So they don't have, you know, 2, 3, 5 as factors. So simple. Okay.